Thank you for giving us that. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to introduce our Biobank project of Tohoku Medical Megabank Organization in Tohoku University and in Iwate Medical University. This is a part of the reconstruction project from the big disaster. Today, at first, I will introduce shortly on cohort studies and data management, then give the presentation of our biobank. In Tohoku Medical Megabank Project, Tohoku University and Iwate Medical University conduct the population cohort studies in Miyagi and Iwate Prefecture. And current and future health problems in the devastated areas are concerned. Many factors, such as family deaths, loss of change of jobs, moving may affect the psychosocial status. Lifestyle change, especially in resident in temporary housing, such as withdrawal from society, living alone, lack of exercise, nutritional imbalance, may also influence lifestyle diseases and risk and orthopedic problems. Exactly, the increase of mental problems such as PTSD and depression and allergic diseases were reported also in children in cross-sectional studies. Therefore, we concern the increase of lifestyle diseases, psychiatric diseases, cognition disorders, cancers, and also orthopedic problems, and also children diseases and developmental problems in this area. So, therefore, we plan prospective cohort studies and biobank project in the tsunami devastated areas. The aim of this project is primarily to clarify the risk of diseases and health problems after disaster in order to deal with the situation and to prepare for the next disaster. And secondly, to facilitate stratified medicine and healthcare in this Riku region. In population cohort study, a Japanese local governments regularly conducted annual health checkup programs of residents. We attend the health checkup sites with these pink jackets and invite residents to our cohort study. This is a professor Fozer who conducts this study and explaining the purpose of our cohort study. Using leaflet, we explain personally and checking the point of information about cohort study, and if the participant reads leaflet and talk with us, and if they want to participate in our study, they check and sign the consent form. Questionnaire is handed over at that time and is returned by a classical mail. And to date, the rate we get agreement is about maybe 70%, and the rate we receive questionnaire and return is above 90%. Biological specimens was collected as additional blood collection in the course of annual health checkup programs. This is a summary of our consent form. Let's participate to long-term cohort study and store data and biospecimen in the biobank and for research use. Not specified, but we specified for like general analysis for proteomics, metabolism, and so on. We write all the researches we can do, and allow access and usage of data and specimens for researchers in profit and non-profit organization after the identification and reviewing process. The participants have a right to withdraw, and we also write about the return of results and incidental findings. In Japanese genome, Japanese genome research guidelines. And this is, in principle, we must return of research result to participant, but maybe it may be difficult to return the results of some analysis. So that is all written in the our consent form. That is a sample and health data collected in the cohort, this cohort. 34 milliliter blood and urine are collected for participant, and 13 of blood is for blood test, and remains are for plasma, buffy coat, and serum and mononuclear cells. And questionnaires have containing such things, and can be shared with other Japanese major cohort studies, and we can share the all data and the samples with maybe with all the major cohort studies in Japan. We added some disaster-related questions that measure lifestyle changes. Then the another cohort study is a three-generation cohort study conducted by Professor Priyama's team. Pregnant women are first recruited in this cohort, then newborn, a newborn and siblings, and father and grandparents are recruited. We are planning to collect samples and data from 70,000 people in 20,000 pedigrees within 3 or 4 years. We collect 34 milliliter blood and urine from father, grandparents, mother. In addition, pregnant women donate blood and urine 2 times with the, during the pregnancy and mother's milk. We also collect cold blood and from siblings and for babies, saliva for DNA extraction and blood, small amount of blood and urine. In follow-up study on three-generation cohort study, we use every 6 months inquiry and medical records. And in Japan, the maternity and the child record book are handed over to every pregnant woman. So that they record the vaccination, health checkup data, records of growth and development. This is a sample page for this book, and this is not this time, but 2 years. And the mothers and parents can check the status of your children, their children, yes or no. And 2 years old, your children can learn, or your children will speak 2 sentences. That is a development check. And maybe, if possible, with financial aid required, a second visit examination are also planned. Then the overview of ToMMo Biobank. We started cohort study in May 2013 and are collecting first visit samples and data. The data of follow-up studies, the data of the disease registration system, census, medical ICT, and so on. All these information and data combined with the identified ID will be stored in ToMMo Biobank and be shared with researchers, and the research results will be back to Biobank. This slide shows the governance of Biobank. Steering committee consists of the members of Tohoku University and Niigata Medical University, and the advice of the LC committee. And this funding of this project is from national government, so several national government working groups have participated on every aspect of our project. So we have already an access committee, which is now discussing on the general rules for data access and sample usage from outside. This part is mainly conducted by Dr. Takai and Onishima, transportation and the identification and data management. The transportation, Sample question is performed in health checkup site in Miyagi Prefecture and Iwate Prefecture, and the center and satellites, and from obstetrician's office. So health checkup site to our biobank is within the day, almost 8 hours, within 8 hours from collection. And Iwate is somewhat distant from Sendai, so next day morning, within 24 hours from collection. And the obstetrician's office from obstetrician's office is required more hours to transport. And usually within 30 hours we receive the samples, but sometimes, especially on Monday, we receive the order samples to biobank. After linkable de-identification, we receive the samples. So de-identification of sample is a different spaces with no connection to internet access. And the cohort system is using the cohort ID. Then we use the biobank ID. That is a de-identification system. And the code system has a different space stored in the different state. And the samples and the questionnaire and the test data are different storage system. The sample data, no, not sample data, the questionnaire data and health checks up data are stored in the cohort database and then integrated database. So this is the cohort information system. Then they identify it to the database. And follow-up studies using medical records, we use a new medical welfare information platform. So from this platform, we also they identified and integrated database. So after to analyze the data from outside of biobank, we release the part of these data to another platform, analysis platform, and we second the identification, and then the data release ID. So researchers from outside use the identified data release ID, only use the data release ID that is not connected to the biobank ID or cohort ID. So that is the sample management storage. We use a LIMS system, laboratory information management system, and this system is in the India and the US system, but we need modification to display in Japanese. And we use a barcode reading and sample storage. Here shows the sample preparation protocols. We use automatic systems and Tecan systems and LIMS in all procedures in biobank. LIMS is very much helpful, This is a manual steps, so very much helpful for extracting mononuclear cells from blood and cord blood. We also start a small number of EV virus, LCL, and activated T cells. Robotics are used in the process of dispensing samples to 2D cord tubes, and then checking and adjusting DNA concentration. Automatic ID reading prevent human error of ID connection. We also use a Brooks system in minus 80 and minus 4, plus 4 degree for DNA storage. And we also use a vapor phase weak nitrogen system for storage of mononuclear cells. And total capacity is maybe 600,000 tubes. 6 million tubes, yeah. We started sample collection at May 2030, and the number of participants increased in this year. We have collected samples from about 60,000 people and extracted DNA from 20,000 people. 60% is Miyagi Prefecture population cohort, and 3 generation is 70%, and the remaining is Iwate Prefecture. And we collect total a million tubes, so we call our biobank megabank, Zagna. And the last is the quality of biobank specimen. So as peripheral blood mononuclear cells are extracted from 5 liter blood and about 10 million cells in stored in two tubes. Survival rates, if we prepare within a day, is above 95%. And the next day, it's 87.4%. I think this is permissible for our storage system. DNA extraction is, we use a QIAGEN autopure system, and from buffy coat of 5 milliliter blood, about 40 micrograms DNA were obtained, and linear to OD to 180, and quite a fluorescent based detection. And almost all can use for the valid for the whole genome analysis, and no obvious DNA fragmentation. And the size of DNA is above 10 kilobase pair. Then we check the integrity of ID management from cohort study to genomic data. So we use a sample tracking system by LIMS, and male or female information in cohort questionnaire and genomic data. And we also use ABO blood type. Because Japanese and women in maternal and child record book, we use in three generation cohort study, that contains the ABO blood type data. So women having the experience of pregnancy knew their ABO blood type. And from the donor blood donation rate in Japan, about 4 or 5% of population in each year. So it is estimated that high percentage of participants knew their ABO blood type from the experience of blood donation. And in addition, majority of Japanese people know their own ABO blood type because if they have known those experiences, because it is believed in Japan that ABO blood type is responsible for one's personality and determine whether couple will get along with each other or not, like astrologic signs in other countries. This is very popular in Japan. So almost all participants know the ABO blood type. Sometimes 1% or 2% have incorrect memory, but very, very, very high. So, and A, 40%, B, 20%, and O, 30%, and AB, 10%, so very balanced, balanced. So, and so we contain the ABO blood type questionnaire in cohort study, and we do the RBC typing and genomic data. Maybe we are now don't do that, but the plasma serum have the anti-A, anti-B, antibody. So plasma tracking is okay. Maybe okay using ABO. So the technical integrity of ID management for study to genomic data. The all participants who have a genomic data are referred to integrated database. We refer to the integrated database that match the six, that every blood type is equal in cohort study and genomic data. Then we also determine the ABO blood type of RBC from all EDTA-NA blood collection samples. And we can perform quantitative PCR analysis of sex and ABO blood type. Therefore, we can check the integrity of sex and ABO blood type data at 4 points in this scheme, at cohort participants data, at sample tubes in biobank, and DNA sipping to researchers, and genomic data. In addition, we store 30% of buffy code in reserve, and can we extract genomic DNA from this one. So we check the integrity of cohort data and genomic data, and if we have any doubts on the integrity of the data, after checking sex and blood type of star DNA, we can test the integrity of sipping DNA and the re-extracted DNA. So we check the 10,000 samples, and sample error rate estimated below 0.5%. And we have already improved the error-prone steps by modifying limbs and by equipping new robotics. Then the data access and sample usage. We are now preparing for this system. The judging criteria for access application we accepted. And its contribution to human society, and especially people affected by the Great East Japan earthquake, is our first criteria. And scientific importance, visibility, relationship to roadmap, and security. But and the access procedures we are discussing, and after completion research project, report of results and raw data obtained using researchers to be submitted to biobank or not, we are discussing now. many points are required to determine that now we are discussing this. This is a summary of biobank. We collect samples from regional population cohort study, 80,000 people, three generation cohort study, 70,000 people. We collected plasma serum, mononucleases, urine, and DNA, and other samples, and analyzed whole genome analysis and transcriptomes and other omics, proteomics, metabolomics, and other omics. And we use storage ICD, and expected result is these. This biomap is constructed in the region affected by the disaster, so we must remind that this biomap is for the health of frequent people to prepare for the next disaster. Thank you for your kind attention.